Aussie biotech Recce Pharmaceuticals has made strong progress in the last 6 months or so, advancing several of its treatments through clinical milestones, as well as gaining support from the US Department of Defense. And to talk us through the latest company updates, Recce CEO James Graham joins me now. Hey, James, great to see you again. Thank you for joining AusBiz.
Hi, Danielle. Great to be with you.
Okay, maybe you could just prioritise in terms of what was the most significant update that was announced today in the last few months since that November, your November AGM.
Look, I think you represent it well. We have had a very busy time period from operational advances through to technical advances. As the world's most advanced new class of antibiotics in over 40 years, we start to see the efficacy potential of our compound in our phase 1-2 Eurosepsis UTI study. It's actually the clinically most advanced study on the most expensive condition treated to date, focused from the underlying urinary tract infection or UTI infection through to the all-out septic state, which is responsible for 30% of underlying sepsis infections. So that's a wonderful advance to see efficacy data points coming through from the IV infusion. The faster you give the compound, the better the patient response, through to the US Department of Defense recognizing the compound as a topical spray agent for the potential against burn wound infections, where we've been recommended for grant funding of around $3.34 million Australian dollars.
Yeah, James, that's really interesting, isn't it? Because burns, of course, they are, well, everything, like the UTIs are awful, the burns are awful, but interesting that it's got such a broad cross application and that the, you are getting this funding. How significant is that $2.2 million injection to accelerating the potential rollout of this treatment?
Look, it is very significant. The 2.2 is 2.2 mil US, which is 3.34 mil Australian. We get 43.5 cents R&D rebate, not only locally, but extended to anywhere around the world. Very uniquely awarded to our company by Oz Industry, providing $55 million of underwritten guarantee that if we spend the money from an R&D context, they will reward it from a non-dilutionary cash injection. So when we look to the US studies, where we see here that we've demonstrated well over 300 efficacious results against deadly bacteria, regardless of the gram stain, regardless of the superbug nature, it gives the sign of new hope in the fight against superbugs for not only the warfighter on the front line, but to the veteran side of things, on a diabetic foot ulcer side of things, to potentially the chemical countermeasures from anthrax threats and other deadly pathogens that come with these chemical bombs that they're so discussing. So to see a overseas government, being the United States government, investing in a foreign entity, frankly just granting to a foreign entity, is a heck of a statement, and we're pleased to receive that.
Just to remind the viewers in terms of lead times and when actually any of these can potentially get off the ground and be widely used in applications.
Yeah, so we've demonstrated in our diabetic foot infection studies in Australia an ability to cure all diabetic foot infections that was treated within that study itself. We're now launching in Indonesia, which has the highest diabetes rate of anywhere in the world, a what's termed a registrational phase 3 study. And I say registrational in inverted commas because that's sweet talk for the final clinical stage study required to then, if successful, be registered for market use or permitted for sale. In good pharmaceuticals, of course, you've got to be approved for sale through the clinical stages before you're allowed to sell this unique compound. So I really see that advancement being so close to a market-ready status of a major patient population that's unmet from all existing therapies is an incredibly unique both commercial time but also a health opportunity, as we see from our opening keynote address at the World AMR Congress coming up later this year.
Okay, and also too, just to remind our viewers in terms of, you've had the $2.2 million injection, but apart from that, how are your financials standing up in terms of cash on hand and the ability to continue to invest?
Look, firstly, and thank you. It's no secret we take a portfolio approach across multiple unmet medical needs for large patient populations. So we do have cash requirements to support those compounds through their regulatory journey, with the objective of getting to market. We received about $11.2 million of non-dilutionary cash by way of Endpoints advanced R&D, or an R&D advance from Endpoints Capital. Endpoints is a family office where they basically gave us upfront cash against our accrued R&D credits, but uniquely in our instance, cash against forward expenditure as well, tied only to the R&D rebate in a future context. So that non-dilutionary cash injection gives us a very nice cash runway to continue to deliver these very important breakthroughs across multiple unmet medical needs in multiple geographic jurisdictions.